British Columbia Museum takes their responsibilities seriously, not only safeguarding priceless pieces of local history, but also making sure everyone in the province has the opportunity to peek at the collection. On This Week in History, we'll meet the people who travel far, sharing the museum's offerings, and why a trip to Colwood was particularly enlightening for the people who live there.
This is a cast of a mammoth tooth.
We brought a variety of objects from the Royal BC Museum's handling collection out to Colwood. This is a Meet the Museum community pop-up.
Pretty cool, huh?
As a provincial museum, our collection belongs to the people of the province. And we have a responsibility to collect, to research, but to also share that with the people of BC. And we're meeting the community where they are. We may not be able to physically come to every community and to set up, so we also have outreach kits. These are little boxes of collections that we put together, and then teachers or educators around the province can borrow them and they can bring the museum to their classroom. So we are doing an outreach event here in Colwood because we are building a new collections and research building in partnership with the government of British Columbia in the Colwood community. So it's been really great to show them some of the collection and to talk about why we need a new building and why we need more space and how we might use that so that people can connect more directly with the collections at the museum. The first question I'm hearing is, well, will we be able to visit? And the answer is absolutely yes.
The Royal BC Collections and Archives building is going to land in a new project in Royal Bay, and it's within walking distance of the new high school. It's going to be within walking distance of our new elementary school. The commercial zone, they are having an international competition to design what this building looks like. And so what's going to happen is people are going to have expectations to build something great beside this amazing $250 million building.
But architectural plans still aren't done yet. But it's not going to be a boring box. I feel very confident in that. We're anticipating classroom spaces, we're anticipating community rooms and spaces where people can gather. So the collection and research building will not have any exhibits. The real magic there is going to be the objects and artifacts themselves. If there's an item being conserved or a piece that's being somehow worked on or maybe an exhibit that's being built or being put together.
It is cool. And you know, one of the things we talk about this is that the Royal Bay area was Emily Carr's summer camp area. So she actually came down to that area to paint during the summertime. And so how fitting is it that we now start to see some of our history landing where people have created that history?
This Week in History, brought to you by the Royal BC Museum, bringing British Columbia stories together.